What is up, guys? So for this video and a couple other videos that will come after this video, I will be reviewing the annual crossover events of the Arrowverse. It's something completely different, something I've never done before, in which I'm not actually reviewing specific episodes of the crossover, of any crossover. I'm reviewing the crossover as an event. So for this one, the first one is definitely a little lower because as an event, it doesn't really work as well. It's definitely two great, enjoyable episodes, like two great episodes. But if you combine them into an event, it doesn't work as well. This crossover event is called Flash versus Arrow, which doesn't really pertain to the second episode. It definitely does to the first, where Flash and Arrow fight each other for a little bit, and it's really like the main focal point of the episode. But in the second episode, the only conflict between the two is an argument about whether or not Oliver should torture people, and a fight at the end that we don't actually see. But even though it was a pretty awesome ending to the crossover, this title doesn't really fit that episode, which makes me think that maybe the crossover event is just the first episode and the second episode is a completely separate crossover, because Flash versus Arrow is the title of the first episode and not the second at all. But still, that's actually not the case. They both are in this crossover event, which doesn't help the crossover as an event. Again, these are two really strong episodes as individual episodes, but as a crossover, it's definitely not as good as a crossover event. But that's not really a problem, considering this is the first time they ever teamed up. This is the first time Flash and Arrow ever teamed up, so they didn't really need to do anything else. Just the spectacle of Oliver and Barry teaming up, or Flash and Arrow teaming up at the time, was completely just awesome, and it was the only thing they needed to do. Just seeing these two team up and also fighting each other and then later teaming up again, it was just so awesome that at that time, because it was like the first time we saw it. At this point, it's just something we see every year, so it's not as cool, so they just have to add more things like aliens or Nazis or Batwoman just to keep us interested. I mean, I would love to see Flash and Arrow team up individually like some other time, like other than the crossover. But like for the annual crossover event, it seems like they really need to add more things at this point. But in the first year, the first annual crossover event, the first crossover event, they didn't need to. Like the villains, they're not that great in this crossover event. I will be going over that later. But they didn't need to be great. The story of the crossover event isn't really connected. But it doesn't need to be connected because this is the first time they ever did it. So even though they're not connected, it was great at the time. Now, comparing to the other crossover events, obviously it doesn't really compare, maybe not to the better ones, just because it doesn't have a linear storyline. But at the time, it was the only thing we had, and at the time it was pretty awesome, except that they just later up the ante not the next year, but the year after that. So it's not fair for this event because the later events exist, but still there's nothing you could do about that. So because these two episodes are completely separate, they do have two completely separate main villains, and I will be going over both main villains. So first of all, the first episode of the crossover had Rainbow Raider as the main villain, and as the main villain, he definitely did the job he was supposed to, but he wasn't much of a main villain at all. Like, really, the main conflict was the Flash versus Arrow. It's very similar to Captain America Civil War or Batman versus Superman. Like, in Captain America Civil War, where the main conflict was Captain America versus Iron Man, or Team Captain America versus Team Iron Man, but the main villain was in the background as Zemo. But I thought Zemo was a lot better, considering we actually saw his motivation and what he was trying to do. And in this one, and it was really the same thing with Rainbow Raider causing Barry to become angry, which made Oliver and Barry fight. First of all, angry Barry in this episode was so well written and well acted by Grant Gustin. Well, well written by the writers, but well acted by Grant Gustin. I actually really enjoyed it, especially like the scene where he was telling Oliver how Oliver is jealous of him. I thought that scene was actually amazing, and it kind of gave me chills. It was so well acted by Grant Gustin, and in general, I loved all the conflict between Oliver and Barry in actually both episodes. In the second episode, there was really the conflict of Oliver was torturing people, and Barry really thought there was something wrong with that, and I really liked that in that episode, especially where the flashbacks of that episode showed Oliver learning how to torture. And even though this crossover event shouldn't really have flashbacks on the Arrow episode, but either way, I thought it really worked with the whole thing. But back to the villain of this first episode, Rainbow Raider was definitely more of a background villain, which does mean usually that the background villains just aren't as good villains because they're really not at the center of the conflict. They still can be very good villains, but Rainbow Raider definitely doesn't really do much. In fact, he doesn't do anything. All he does was whammy Barry and then leave, and then once the conflict between the Flash and Oliver is over, or the Flash and Arrow is over, he comes back, but he immediately gets captured and gets put in the pipeline. So he didn't really do much as a main villain. He didn't really do anything. But like I said a couple times already, he didn't need to, because just seeing Barry and Oliver team up for the first time and then fighting each other, that's really all you needed for spectacle and conflict for the first episode. So Rainbow Raider, he did his job. He wasn't a very good villain, but he did not need to. So before I get to the main villain of the second episode and the second episode in general, I want to stay in the first episode for a little bit and talk about the Flash versus Arrow fight scene, which was the namesake of the episode and the namesake of the crossover event in general, which is really what they marketed this crossover event off of, which was Oliver and Barry going toe-to-toe in a fight, which on paper doesn't really sound fair, and it definitely is not. Like, at this point, Oliver wouldn't stand a chance. Like in season 4 of The Flash and season 6 of Arrow, Oliver would not stand a chance in the slightest in a fight scene. But in this at this point, Oliver was experienced already. Flash had just begun really as a speedster, and he hasn't really unlocked a lot of his powers at that point. So a fight scene between the two definitely is more plausible, and the way they really, really went about it, and then the fight scene between The Flash and Arrow was great. And really creative, and even though, like, really in spite of the fact that Oliver really shouldn't stand a chance, even at this point, like, it's definitely more plausible, but either way, the Flash has superpowers. Like he said at the end of the second episode, Oliver is, like, basically standing still when the Flash is running, so the fight really shouldn't work, but it actually does. It's really great, it's really, really creative. I love how it was handled, and the namesake of this crossover is definitely lives up. This fight scene definitely lives up to the namesake of this crossover. And the main villain of the second episode of the crossover event, which by the way, the second episode is titled The Brave and the Bold, but the second episode, the main villain is Captain Boomerang, who was definitely a better main villain than Rainbow Raider, but that's just because he needed to be a better main villain than Rainbow Raider, because he was the main conflict of this episode, and we already saw a full episode of Barry and Oliver and the Flash and Green Arrow, or Arrow at the time, teaming up and fighting each other, so that wasn't really much, or it was a lot less of a spectacle in this episode. So Captain Boomerang did have a lot more on his shoulders than Rainbow Raider as a villain. Also, considering he was the main conflict of this episode, that's definitely a lot more than Rainbow Raider had to handle, and Captain Boomerang is not the best main villain. I just rewatched the episode and I just realized how cheesy Captain Boomerang was. It's like every single time he talked, he made a boomerang pun, like what goes around comes around, or how boomerangs come back to haunt you, or like how he likes boomerangs because it comes back to haunt you. Just so many boomerang puns that it got so tiring, and I didn't really realize how cheesy he was until I just rewatched the episode, and he is just so cheesy, which would work in like a cartoon episode. If this whole thing was a cartoon, then it would definitely work a lot better, but it isn't. It's a live action TV show, so it definitely does not work as well as it would in a cartoon, which is just Captain Boomerang felt so cartoony in this episode, and it just made for a pretty bad main villain for the second episode, which kind of sucks for the second episode because they didn't really have any other conflicts, or at least physical conflicts, because like I said, there was an argument between Oliver and Barry whether or not Oliver should torture people and what that does to Oliver, which by the way, the arguments in both these episodes were great, like the argument about what I just said about torture in the first episode, where Barry was forced to be angry and then he argued with Oliver. Both of these episodes did those really, really well, but those were just arguments, and really the physical action of the first or the second episode was was Captain Boomerang, and he didn't really do that very well. He was not a very good villain. So in conclusion, this crossover event as an event, as really one storyline, it definitely does not work, because it's just one episode, one storyline. It stops and then it continues into a different storyline, which might be a problem if it wasn't supposed to do that, which it was. It's just really two different storylines. Really, the thing I compare it to is Luke Cage season 1, where it was one storyline and then it stopped when, spoiler alert, the main villain died and was completely replaced by somebody completely different from a different storyline. If that happened in this episode, or in this crossover where there was a main villain and it was supposed to be the main villain of both episodes, and then it just they died, and then a different villain came over and did what that villain was trying to do, it definitely would not have worked as well. But it was two completely separate episodes, so it's not as much of a problem. But like I said, I will be reviewing these episodes as crossover events. So as an event, as a crossover event, as one storyline, this crossover event is not good. But for the sake of this review, I'm not actually going to count that as like a flaw on this crossover event, because again, it wasn't supposed to be. So like I said, the next three crossover events shouldn't be a problem with this whole thing, because all of the episodes are completely connected as a storyline. But for this event, it is a little bit different. But either way, I will give this crossover event an 8 out of 10. Again, it would be a lot higher if the two episodes actually were more connected and had a better linear story, as well as if they had better villains. That's a big part of why it's 8 and not maybe 9 or something, because the villains were not very good, especially Captain Boomerang, where he needed to be a better villain. So what do you think about this crossover event? Let me know in the comments down below, and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and stay tuned for my review of the next crossover event, which is Heroes Join Forces.